everyone. Again, John Bruno back at you, Fiberm Smith Sales and FIS University. I want to talk to you about a subject that's really near and dear to my heart and something that is really the most important step in fiber optics, hands down, and that's cleaning. We need to be thinking about cleaning our fiber and our connectors and our equipment really all the time. That should be the first and last thought that we have. Independent surveys show that 85% of all fiber-related issues are related to dirt and contamination. So think about that. We can save 85% of our issues just by being clean. When I do a video on microscopes, you're gonna see just exactly what contamination looks like. And contamination, you know, leads to attenuation, which shortens our distances. It maximizes optical return loss, so we get a lot of back reflections that can damage our equipment, that can hurt our signal, and again, shorten distances. Dirt can create shatters, chips, and cracks on our connectors. Really not a good thing to have happen. And again, it's one of the most basic things and fundamentally the most important thing we can do. Now, there's different ways we can clean. There's different procedures. There's different pieces of equipment that you can buy. One of the simplest things, and really one of our most popular, are one-click cleaners. This is a 2.5 millimeter one-click. So that will clean anything with a 2.5 mil ferrule, like your STs, SCs, and FCs. When we look at the LC connector, it has a smaller 1.25 millimeter ferrule, and it won't clean those. It just is not a very precise fit. So we have a different cleaner for the LC or the 1.25 mil ferrules. The one click, if we look at it straight on in the barrel here, there's a cleaning, very small thread cleaning tape here. And inside the unit, you can see the spool here. That's the spool that's releasing the material. This can do about 525 clicks before it's used up. We're talking about 5 or 6 cents a click. Very affordable, very popular material, our item. If we need to extend this to go longer reach, we can for panels. The nice part about this is it spins and cleans at the same time. And literally, as its name suggests, one click and we've cleaned the end face. Again, can't be much easier. What I really like about this is we can take the top off and we can clean our female ports. Really, if we think about it, that might even be significantly more important than cleaning the connectors. So if you think about equipment having a connector on the inside and we weren't to clean that and we were to damage those ferrules, very expensive. I know doing that to an OTDR can cost about $1,000 to fix. So that 5 cents a click really isn't that big of a deal. So this is one of the easiest things you can do. This is a dry clean. I have had a lot of guys actually put a dab of alcohol on the end, clean, so they got the wet clean again, and the dry piece will clean up the wet that was left behind, or any other cleaning solution, doesn't have to be alcohol. Again, when we talk about alcohol, we want to use a 99.9% pure isopropyl when we use it. But again, that's a very effective cleaner. One of your traditional methods would be to use your wipes here. And in class, I always ask, what's special about these wipes? And I always hear, well, they're no lint. But if you look very closely, under it says fiber optic wipes, it says low lint task wipes. Meaning there is some lint that can be left behind. Very effective, very most popular wipe that we sell. They aren't lint free. We do have other options. We sell in different configurations. These are what we call lint-free, non-woven dry wipes are some of the things that you'll hear for these. You'll see that some of these, the low lint ones, you know, they're a paper material that can tear very easily. These are very hard, almost a cloth-like material. This is your no lint wipe. More expensive, obviously, a better clean. Traditionally, we would always see people cleaning, and I'm a big believer in whether you use the low lint or the no lint is to be aggressive during your clean. So I like to moisten, and you can hear that squeak, and then we rub our thumb across the tip, and that's a very effective cleaning method. I like to actually follow it up with a dry wipe just to clean up any excess alcohol that might have, or cleaning material that might have been left behind. Same thing with the non-woven, same process. If we were to follow, you know, the standard as written, the de facto standard, you can see this little QB device here. It's a cleaning platform. If we were to follow the letter of the law, draw to cleaning, and I don't see this happen often, but as written, technically you're supposed to clean in what we call a star pattern. So we'll take our wipe, put it on a pad that has some give to it so that we can actually do a domed clean, and we wet this in the center. And the star pattern is such, you're supposed to spin the fiber in the liquid, the connector, and then pull away from the liquid in a star pattern. So this is what we call the wet to dry method, and really the de facto best possible way to clean. Again, I don't see that a lot in the industry, but as written, that is really the highest standard for cleanliness. But really, regardless, you know, before we take a connector out of a pack, you saw me remove the dust cap from this LC, right? This was we manufactured this connection here, and it's probably been cleaned 20 times before it ever was to be shipped off. As soon as we put that dust cap on, you know, there's contaminants in a dust cap. Because it's a tight fit, it can cause static, and the static can attract dust even when we don't touch the dust. So, you know, it's really a first and last thought issue. As I mentioned earlier, we constantly have to be cleaning. So even a brand new cable off the spool or out of the bag, really we need to clean. When we plug it in, we need to clean. When we detach it, we need to clean. Before and after, in and out of a microscope, we need to clean. Really, if the question is, should I clean it? The answer is always yes. Remember this, if you have a dirty connector that you didn't know was contaminated and you cleaned it, you did a very good thing. If you had a connector that was clean, you weren't sure, and you cleaned it, you did nothing wrong. So there's really no negative about cleanliness. And everything, as you can see, falls back to cleanliness. Every technical support call, the first question is if we cleaned everything. And in another video, I will show you what contamination looks like and how easily we can contaminate a connector in a microscope. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope that I hear from you and that cleanliness is your number one priority. So thanks again.
Subscribe to our channel for new videos.